Hello everyone. I had some real fun lately. I've been lucky enough to pull off an 8 versus 8. Normally the game limit is 6 versus 6. They've tried 8 versus 8 before and they've stated that this is the mode they want for the game. And dropping into this game, I got kind of excited and I'm just running head first into this without really thinking about it. I'm running a Stingshot because they buffed the stings, or they changed the trajectory of the stings and they buffed the jump of the Shon. So that's why I'm running this bot, to test it out. And look, this is a guy I don't know. How that almost never happens, man. All of these other guys are pretty well known to me. Let's check out that jump. Woo! Get out of the way, get out of the way. Come on, come on, come on. Yep. Woo! Okay, I'm safe. And my chest is simply is just red. Oh, okay, check out this guy. So, stings, they're not useless anymore, but their damage is really low. And the new jump of the Shon makes it kind of like it used to be back in the day. Mites are still vastly superior in my opinion. Mites are currently so good that they're a problem. And I don't really want to see them nerfed to the mites, but it's hard to say how such a dominating bot should be balanced without nerfing it in some respect. Who is this guy, by the way? I'm completely a cowabunga. I don't know him either. Yeah. Okay, and here's a might buddy of mine, and now and game should be over for cowabunga. Because we are just applying the fog lock and there's nothing he can do about it. The stings have horrible damage though. As you see, I've been doing 500 damage per sting clip if all of my missiles hit. And the stings are still pretty easy to dodge. As you can see from the graphics, I realized that, yeah, it's Steel Convoy end of the game mode and it's all about that big red star over there. It's currently white because someone killed the guy who captured it. Now you can see from the graphics, General Disarray is the guy who's trying to capture the Steel Convoy. And so every one of us on the blue side should try to kill General Disarray. Sting's range is a bit hopeless. Ace McQuaid trying to do some real damage or difference to this fight. It's about now I should realize that I'm running around in a Stingshot with the one sting and I'm not really doing anything for my side except for having fun, of course. So I'm bringing out the Sting Ravager. This is probably completely gonna turn the tide. For those of you who don't know, I have a penchant for the Sting Ravager. I might even have made a video about it. I'm not sure if I ever released that. I will have to check. But the Sting Ravager is a pretty fun bot and it's honestly, it's the worst Ravager build. But this is Battle of Titan, so no build is useless. It's just that this build is less useful than all the other Ravager builds. It doesn't mean that it's a useless bot. It's pretty useful, actually. But it's hard to see this ever seeing play unless the stings get buffed. Now stings aren't useless, as you can see. I hit Wild Blin. Sorry. I have no idea who that guy might be. I'm running full automations on my hammer because this bot isn't supposed to dogfight like this. I'm supposed to stay in cover most of the time and pop out and unleash my stings and a full hammer clip. Yeah, I'm just running headfirst into this. So at this point I'm realizing that we have the steel convoy and we're trying to retreat, and this guy is blocking our way, because that's the way we want to go with the steel convoy. So now I'm trying to distract this guy, and hopefully the rest of my team can get the convoy home. Yeah, I don't actually remember how this went. I lost my other sting and there goes my hammer. So yeah, time to change the Titan. And Sting Nelly. Yeah, this video was primarily made to check out the new stings. And I will say this, stings are no longer useless, and there's, as you can see from this fight, there's a lot of people who's trying out the stings. But are they still viable as of 2.2.3? Of course some people will say yes. Of course some people thought Hitler was a brilliant chap as well. You shouldn't listen to people. You should listen to me primarily. Or, you know, make your own judgment about things. But in my opinion, stings need kind of a buff. Because I don't see myself running any of these builds that I'm currently playing. Here you can demonstrate... Here I really demonstrate that range is a factor for running stings, and I'm completely ignoring that cormorant who's landing behind me and unleashing at me. But yeah, I was completely having fun and wasn't thinking or playing tactically or anything. Because 8v8, man, all of these players are humans. You know, you can't predict all of these players. It's impossible. It's so different from playing against AI. And this is where the game really, really shines. And this game truly reminded me of why I play Battle of Titans. What's fun with this? You know, this... if every game was something like this, this game would be a brilliant success. Because this is so much fun. And look how beautifully it runs. And yeah, I don't know, man. I'm playing like shit, but I'm having so much fun. If I'd have had range extenders on this Volgor, I could probably have hit that Venom guy. And here I realized that, yeah, okay. This game was about the convoy, not about the shooting and stuff. So yeah, there's a completely unknown guy. We had to unload a bit on him and we tried to folder our own dude just for reasons. You can see tormentors, they still suck. Oh my god, get rid of the knockback, please. It's so ridiculous. And there are some people who claim that the tormentors... Oh, try folgering your own guy again. Yeah, that's right. Great. There's some people who try to claim that tormentors need the knockback for them to be viable, because otherwise they can't protect against mites. But I don't want a fucking illogical science fiction weapon that uses the force to push you back, because there is no science on earth that will allow you to stop mid-jump and be pushed back by small bullets of presumably lead. Anyway, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Try the test server if you have the option to do it. It's brilliantly fun. And yeah, stay tuned for more. Thank you for watching. See you next time.